can't exactly fire him. He's your partner. You are partners.
Thank you. Fire me. Look, I am not leaving here without my piece of the action. Do you understand me? And then I will be the former artistic director of Chippendales. That's a fact. And I will use it.
You use the name of Chippendales? I'll sue you.
Oh, you sue me.
Sue me.
Enough.
Sue me. You'll lose. Tell
enough.
Him, Stan.
Come on, sue me. Tell you.
You'll lose.
Tell him. Tell
enough.
Him.
Go ahead. Do what you're doing. Destroy the company and both of you walk away with nothing. Now let's sit down. Stephen, sit down. And let's build some firewalls here.
All right. Banerjee owns the Chippendale name. All present and future clubs and receives 100% of all merchandise revenues. Tenoya receives 20% ownership in the 5 new clubs and 20% of all profits. Tenoya agrees to maintain established caliber of all shows. Tenoya is responsible for the full production of the shows, including hiring, firing, and training of all hosts, waiters, and performers. Tenoya shall receive a conceived, produced, and directed by credit on all local advertising. In return, Tenoya agrees not to tour and or enter into any new marketplace of any kind, in any way, without Banerjee's prior written consent. All right, gentlemen, that's it. Any questions?
You can come over to my place. I'm not really a Chippendales kind of jippy. I can make you lasagna. You like lasagna?
I'm Dr. Manager.
Can we help you, officer?
Yeah, I want to see a man. Get your hands off. Hey, hold on. What's the problem here?
I gotta go. I'm sorry. Can I call you? I'm sorry.
Oh, it's okay.
We don't know each other. Yeah, what's going on?
What's the problem here?
You got some kind of complaint.
The problem is LAPD. We're investigating some lewd behavior in the parking lot.
Oh, man.
Talk to the owner.
What?
The owner's not in tonight. So I'll tell you what. You come back at 3 o'clock tomorrow. Talk about it, we'll get it straightened out.
A little bit less moisture on the forehead, a little bit more volume in the hair, a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. That's too much, everybody out, move. I'm gonna shoot now.
We should do a special calendar with just Sean, no one else.
Okay, all right,
I'll see. You wanna talk to me, Steve? I'm not sure about the cowboy outfit. I don't think we'll use it.
What do you mean? I've been working on this for over 2 weeks.
Forget it. There's a party tonight up in Bel Air. I want you to take 4 of the dancers, take them in the van and bring them back. And try and get Sean to go as well, because they always ask for him.
Look, Steve, I'm not doing this for tips anymore, man. All right? I want to cut of this up front.
Oh?
Yeah. Look, I talked to Mark when he came out here in his calendar shoot. Okay? I know he gets a piece of the action, and he works for Nick, and he runs tours to Philly and Atlantic City. This is the same thing, and I want the same deal.
Wait. Just wait a second. You said Nick was running tours to Atlantic City?
Yeah. They've been SRO for 6 straight weeks.
Okay. You get Sean to go, you get 200. Look, the other dancers, they're like the big children. They don't think about anybody but themselves. You think about the company. You think about Chippendales, and I appreciate that. Stan? He's running tours to Atlantic City. No, he did not have my permission. No. I want to sue him. No. Just sue him. Then what do I have to do then?
Las Vegas for women. annoy me. What? Anybody else see what's going on here?
See what, Tony?
What, you think this was an accident?
What are you, a detective now?
What, you think Nick just, what, he went out and he fell on a lead bullet? Come on, open your eyes.
What kind of proof do you have?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
What's up? A member of our family's dead. But Nick would want us to stick together.
I agree.
So that's what we're gonna do. You guys are going to hear a lot of different things from a lot of different people. You need to shut it out. You want to talk to somebody, you talk to somebody in here, because we're still family.
We dancing tonight?
Yeah, we're going on. All right?
Chippendale's finished, man. We should cancel the show in Nick's honor. This place is gonna die without him, man. And nobody can do what he did.
Just take it easy, Scotty, all right? Let's see what Steve has to say.
The hell with Steve, man! He hated Nick!
Take it easy,
Scotty. No, man, he probably put the hit on Nick himself.
Hey, cool it, man, all right? You're drunk. Everybody here knows that Steve wouldn't hurt anybody.
Go to hell.
I've seen Steve when he wasn't just a nice guy. He always kissing his ass.
Hey, give me that bottle.
Save the bitch job for later. Let's show a little respect. You just cool your jets, Scotty. Come on.
This ain't helping anything.
Hey, guys. Whoa.
I think we're all agreeing that no one.
No one can replace Nick. It's a terrible thing. He closed the New York club in his honor.
Just tell us there isn't going to be a show here tonight.
We're a family. Chippendales is sending a floral tribute to the funeral on Sunday. But tonight, the show must go on. We have 2 busloads of Japanese tourists coming. We can't cancel. It wouldn't be good for our reputation, and I know Nick would have understood. If anyone wants to talk to me about this, I'll be in the bar.
There are only 2 eyewitnesses, the elevator man and a man in the other office. This is a composite.
To be any one of 100 delivery guys bringing coffee.
I think it could have been a lover of Nick DeNoia's.
Were you Nick DeNoia's lover?
Listen, you've taken over in the club as a dance director. How'd you get along with Nick?
You guys don't have a clue, do you? Nick was my friend, okay? He's my mentor. Some guy walks in, puts a bullet in his head, and you think I did it?
I'm sorry.
DeNoia knew hundreds of people.
We're trying to cover all our angles here. We haven't got much besides this sketch to go on.
Irene, are you coming? What time is your doctor's appointment?
I'm so sorry. You look wonderful.
I look as big as a house. And would you please stop worrying? We're going to have plenty of time to go to the office.
Let's forget about the office. It's not a good place. There's no fresh air.
Well, could we go to the beach then and have brunch? I'm starving. So is she. Is that a yes?
Yes.
Okay. In we go. Okay, I'm good. Thank you. Fine.
All right, guys, let's pull it together here, okay? Steve's gonna be up soon.
Yeah, these feel great.
Steve is gonna love these guys. They're young, they can dance.
So how is Vegas?
Oh, Vegas is heaven. I mean, Robbie and me, we go out after the show in the desert, you know, look at the stars. She got a job dealing with the Big Lion, so she sneaks me in to see Siegfried and Roy.
Oh, it's Vegas, baby.
Yeah? Oh, Steve's on his way up.
Oh. All right, let's line up, guys. Take it off. Let's take it off. Come on, all off. Let's go. Let's go. Come on, off. What are you doing? Steve, these are the dancers for the Vegas show, man. What do you think?
and they're ready to go.
I'm going to talk to you first. Stephen. Stephen, we've had three reports this week from Kansas City. Now, this is exactly what I was warning you about. They're like weeds. You cut them down in one place, they're just going to pop up somewhere else. Look, we've got a new judge, new jurisdiction. We've got to start all over again. Whatever it takes, we're going to stop them. Carol, I want you to go down to Kansas City and check out these bootleg shows. They're all Nick's old people. They don't know you, you don't know them. They're screwing us, and we need to get down there tonight.
I'm not going
to
be your spy, Steve.
You're not a spy. You're our legal witness. You're smart. You know the business. It doesn't matter if we shut them down or we hire their dancers for our Chippendale tours. I trust you. You be the judge.
All right.
Stephen, stand. Find out what she has to cover to get a good case on these people. Give her one of those mini tape recorders or something. You. Come with me.
Keep her accent.
Steve, I got a new idea for a routine. It's an Elvis impersonation. I'm trying it out with one of the dancers. He's right outside, man. I can have him show it to you. What do you think?
How many years have you been working for me, Dave?
Well, it's going on 7 years.
I made you assistant manager at the club. Then I put you in charge of local parties. Now you're running tours to Las Vegas. You're part of the Chippendale family, and I've always trusted you. You think I'm stupid?
Steve, man, forget Elvis. If I did something out of line with that, I apologize.
I hired private detectives to inspect all our tours. You've been clipping the box office by undercounting.
I would never do that to you. Never. Steve, I'm shocked, man. You gotta let me check this out. I know
I've already checked it out. Don't worry. I'm not going to fire you. You've been with me a long time, and I'm very fond of you. Just a little bit on the side. Nothing big. Don't make the same mistake twice. Get out. I don't want to talk to you about this again.
That son of a bitch knows that we let your travel club in that night.
But we weren't trying to cheat anybody.
He warned me, okay? He's gonna do me like he did Nick.
Bullet right in the head.
Dave, do not fall apart on me. Don't let him mess with your head like this, okay?
Babe, you know I can't handle letting you get hurt.
I know, and I love you, okay? Quit, Steve. Go out on your own. I mean, what does it take to run your own tour? You don't already know, honey.
I'd like to ask you a few questions about the period 1986 to 1987.
I'll tell you what I can. It's been a while now.
Mr. Banerjee, how closely were you involved in the operation of the New York Club back then?
No, I left everything up to Nick. That was how we worked it. He was on the East Coast, I was on the West Coast.
How you doing? Sit down. I told you, no meetings till I called you.
I didn't want to see you. I had to see you. The FBI came to my office about Nick.
And the first thing he did was call me, right?
Don't worry, I didn't tell them anything. I called you from a payphone, and I drove around the hills for an hour. Somebody must have talked. Why are you laughing? I came here to warn you.
I know. You are one lucky Indian, Steve.
What do you mean?
Hitter's dead. He was a junkie. He had his last fix. Now there's no way that you can trace anything about Nick. Smile, pal. You got no worries anymore.
of talk behind my back. But they do what I tell them. No arguments.
That's because you're the man that tells somebody to go to hell. And then you send them. Right?
Molestation and
what
assault.
What are you talking about?
The woman is charged with you raped and assaulted upstairs in the storeroom of the Chippendales nightclub last Friday night. Help them, let's go.
That's ridiculous. I didn't rape anybody.
With the proper time, you have the right to call your lawyer. Tell that anything you say may be used against you in a court of law. Hey, you understand your right?
Yeah. Baby, call Steve. Get him on the phone. Sean, how you feeling?
What does it say to women?
What? Was there any police around?
I think Jack let you off.
Hey, I told the truth, all right? At the time, it was a mutually agreeable experience. That's all I have to say.
All right, move it. I'm going to close up. Anybody else?
I just want to say how much I appreciate you all for giving Sean your support. The Chippendale family stood together. Yeah. And it wasn't just a victory for Sean. It was our victory. The days of the police harassing Chippendales are over. Yeah. We're going to be open soon. We're going to be opening a new club in the LA County jurisdiction where they appreciate and encourage the adult entertainment industry. Today we showed everyone we're proud of what we do. We're proud to be part of Chippendales.
Put him down there. I'm like some kind of god. He always thinks this whole thing is his idea. I wouldn't even be at Chippendales if it wasn't for Nick.
Yeah, Nick was good, man. Sure as good as he ever was.
The public continues to support Chippendales, so I hope everybody eats up quickly and then goes straight back to work as soon as possible. Thank you. Just kidding.
I want to talk to you about something. Hey, buddy, man, I'm glad it all worked out for you.
Hey, yeah, buddy. Thanks, I appreciate the help. Listen, you need a ride to the airport?
Yeah, man. I'll give you a call in the morning before I take off.
Okay, no problem. Thanks. Okay.
Man, did you see that? Steve gives me a bad feeling. He was watching us.
Yeah, of course he's watching us.
Man, I've been waiting for the right time for this. I'm starting my own tour. I got four of my dancers gonna come with me. We're jumping the show to London. We'll hire the rest of the local dancers there.
London? What, are you crazy? You think Steve is just gonna let you steal his show?
He can't touch us. We don't go near the Chippendales name. Right? We got the whole country to ourselves.
I've got a theatrical agent checking out bookings right now.
I want you with me, man. I need you to do the show. I give you full artistic control, just like Nick. I want you to be my partner, full partner. You want to bring some dancers with you, man? That's just a plus. How does that sound?
I don't know, man. Have you told Steve you're leaving yet?
Not yet.
Come in, Dave. Who did you leave in charge in Denver?
Stanley's handling it.
It was great. The whole Chippendale family was here behind Sean.
Yeah, I was really pulling for him, you know, but I hope he gets his head on straight. Guy's been getting laid since he was 12, you know, he can't break the habit. But that's not why I came. I brought him my receipts. I want to clear my accounts with you.
What's the matter? What does this mean?
Well, nothing's the matter, Steve. I'm leaving the company. My letter of resignation is in the envelope, along with my statement of expenses. Look, it's been a long run, man, and I have learned a lot. I want to thank you for that.
You don't want to do this. Not now that Chippendales is doing so well.
You wanted to settle down and get married, haven't you? Oh, do you need a job here in this office? We need a scout for dancers full time. Now we have 5 shows on the road.
Look, I appreciate the offer, Steve. You know, I do. But I got some ideas of my own that I want to work on. You know, there comes a time in every man's life where he wants to work on his own thing.
Chippendales is your family. I know you've done good work here, and I need you here. You don't really want to leave. Who's been talking to you? It's Mark, isn't it? Mark thinks I had something to do with Nick's death.
Well, Steve, that's not it, all right? It's just time for me to go. That's all.
So you're tired of stealing from me? Is that it? Who are you gonna steal from now?
Goodbye, Steve.
Hello? Hello?
Yeah, hello.
Carl?
Yeah.
Where are you?
I'm in Maine, Steve.
Wetting it down? Or...
No, it's butt-ass nowhere.
Did anyone follow you?
No, I had to drive all the way down from Montreal before I called you. Otherwise, I'd have to use an operator.
Okay, so I want you to go to every club in Montreal.
No.
I want you to find out exactly...
No.
...exactly where he intends to work. Do you hear me?
No, Steve, listen. The whole Montreal thing was a scam. He met some guys and a woman at the Montreal airport when he landed. They had a ticket waiting for him. 5 of them caught a plane to London. They're gone.
Drive to Boston. I'll wire you some money so that you can fly to London.
No! I am not going to London. I'll see you back in L.A.
It's nice to be remembered.
Now, you're a dancer from the heyday of Chippendales. What do you think about that phenomenon and why it's endured so much and didn't just become a passing fad like everybody thought it would be?
Well, I think you have to say it's Steve Banerjee's vision. He's been running Chippendales since the beginning and he keeps coming up with new ways to reinvent the business.
Yeah, but you know, when it really comes down to it, it's still just, you know, good-looking male hunks taking their clothes off for women, isn't it?
Amazing, isn't it?
All right, John Boyd from Chippendales. Yeah, I see the man who started it all over here, Steve. Steve, must be a great night for you, but you know, I understand that there's an opening tonight in London simultaneously, something called Adonis. Is that yours as well? Is this Chippendales International now?
They're a rip-off. They won't last. We open Chippendales in London in 1 month.
Good luck.
London in 1 month.
All right, there's Steve going into the opening of Chippendales here at Carlos and Charlie's. It's a glittering night all around here, and of course, many more interviews still to come.
I don't need that crap from you anymore. Get that straight, all right?
Worked together before. $8,000 down payment, like before. You find someone to help me with my problem.
I told you, I am not interested in your problem.
I mean, can't you understand we're crazy to even be talking about this anymore? We got away with it once. We shouldn't even be talking about this again. These guys are in England. You cannot get a damn gun into England.
I have contacts in Vegas. Maybe I'll talk to them about you.
Are you threatening me, Steve?
You can take it how you want.
Are you threatening me,
you
Steve?
You take it how you want.
I've thought about this. We can use poison. They poison the wells and mad dogs in India. At least think about it.
Good thing I finally ran into you. You know, I've been looking ever since Sammy told me you got out.
Yeah, I couldn't make it stick. My appeal went through.
That was a federal rap, huh?
Yeah.
You were lucky. Do me a favor. Throw that stuff off the chair. Just put it down anywhere. Good. Okay. You know why you're here. But before we start, I just want to know that you're up for this. I want to hear it again. Just to avoid any mistakes.
I'm going to pop somebody for you in London. I need the money. I'm here. You're going to tell me about it. What the hell else do you want to talk about?
Okay. Okay. I'll show you what I got. But first things first, no way are you going to bring a gun into England. That ain't going to happen.
No, I don't got those connections. I've been in London, but not on business, you know?
Yeah, I know. Look at this.
It's a nice bag.
Really see how nice.
Potassium cyanide, my friend. I got it for the gophers. I got enough to kill a million of those little bastards. You, on the other hand, don't need that much. Just a couple of drops.
This is what they use in the Texas gas chamber. The little pellets just drop in the acid. So how do I give it to them? They ain't gophers.
Use a syringe. You inject them. Bump up against them in the street and stick them. Your code name's Strawberry for talk on the phone. These are your primary targets. Memorize the pictures and lose them. If you can't get to either one of them, hit anybody that's with them. We're sending a message here.
What's that, Daddy?
That's a lion, darling. Look, it's like a great big pussycat, isn't it? Yeah. See, it's got sharp teeth. And we can actually go to a zoo and see a real lion if you want. Mm-hmm. Oh. See, she has a real artist's eye for beautiful things. Let's see. No, I don't think we'll look at that.
But I want to see it, Daddy.
No, no, no. It's not good for little girls. Look, come with Daddy. Come with Daddy. Come with me. We'll have lots of time to see more pictures. We'll travel all over the world and see all the galleries and all the museums. And we'll look at beautiful pictures together. Okay?
Okay.
Want to see Mommy?
Go on.
Big girl.
Oh!
Mr. Benedict, a call for you.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm calling from a payphone at LAX. Strawberry's on the way.
Hey, listen up! Party's up the street at the Ruffs and Snugs, so let's celebrate! Look, come on. Hey, I gotta bore you, man, for a minute, though.
Wait. I'm sorry, for what?
I'll bring him back, don't worry.
No, I know you.
I'll be back in a minute, though.
I'll treat him gently.
What's up?
Listen, I didn't want to tell you this before the ceremony. The theater preempted us again in London. They're extending the current show, which means we're not going to be allowed in London, period.
Well, what are we going to do? We still got that gig on German TV, so we'll just have to take that. Hopefully we'll get a tour out of it or something. That's what we got, right?
Yeah, we'll keep this to yourself, huh? Make for a better party.
Oh, you think so?
Brad, alert, okay? That's long enough. You've been long enough. I want my man back. All right? So, baby, let's go.
I'm sorry to bring you in this way, but we don't know too much ourselves at this point. Now, it seems an American with a prior criminal record arrived in London and contacted the FBI liaison officer at the American Embassy. Now, this man claims that he was hired to kill both of you with lethal injections of cyanide.
What? Now he's gonna do us?
So, this is a credible threat, then?
You're damn right it is. There's only one guy who would do this. And it's Steve Banerjee.
He killed one person that we know already.
Yeah, Strawberry's turned. I think he's talking to the feds. Steve.
Did you hear me? Are you listening to me? We gotta meet at the burrito place.
Steve. Steve, are you listening to me? We gotta talk.
Are you there?
We'll sit here. You talk, I listen.
I'm glad you agreed to meet me. My client, Carl Ramon, was arrested on suspicion of soliciting the murder of two male dancers in England. Bad news? Carl fled the country to avoid trial. He was pleading not guilty. And we're planning a vigorous defense, because the only witness against Carl is an FBI informant, convicted criminal named Ballard. Carl knows he's made it serious on himself by running away, but he said you'd understand. He won't do more jail time.
My advice? Tell him to come back to the United States and face the charges. Because I don't think he's gonna make a very good fugitive.
What's in the suitcase? I mean, even you could have a gun, you know?
Take off your shoes.
Sure. There's no way they're gonna make a tape of you and me. Without a tape?
No.
It's your word against mine. Come on, Steve. Steve. I didn't talk. They didn't get to me, Steve. I mean, thanks to you, I couldn't make bail. They had 4 months of trying.
That's your fault. You should have never have gotten involved with Strawberry. That should never have happened. It was idiotic. He was an FBI informant. How could you not have known?
Do you even remember how much pressure you put on me about your Las Vegas friends? I mean, I took what I could get. You said you were going to help me, Steve. You hung up on me.
Listen to me. They know Nick's dead. They know I was involved with Nick. They questioned me after Nick's killing. They know I was involved with you. They know you were involved with Strawberry. They questioned you. They put these things together, and now they think I'm involved in Nick's death.
Oh, Steve, listen to me. They never mentioned Nick. In the whole 4 months that I was there, they never even brought up his name. If they thought you were involved, they would have arrested you. You'd be in the same shape I am now. Yeah, 408.
We're next door. Go for it.
No, lady, wrong room.
The FBI. They're checking if we're here.
Come on. Be serious. That's impossible. I mean...
This is the FBI we're talking about. They can do anything. They could be in the next room next door.
Okay, I understand, but you picked this, will you? You picked this hotel yourself. You picked it on the fly. Come on. Steve.
All right.
Listen. Okay? I listened. Come on, buddy. Calm down. It's okay. Come on, Steve.
Even if they put a gun to my head, I'm not going to confess. They don't have a solid case against me. They have a good case, but it's not enough. For them to arrest me, they need you. They're using you to put pressure on me. You're the one they want.
Don't even think about it. Just put it out of your mind. They can't get to me, Steve. That's why we're here. Come on, pal, let's put this behind us.
They don't have the proof that I gave you the money for Nick's killing. They don't have the proof that I bought you the gun. They don't have the proof that I gave you the address where Nick's office is. You can't tell the truth without going to prison yourself.
You got that right. They got me on tape.
Should help. $250,000.
Why'd you take so long? Why'd you hang up on me, Steve?
Because I was afraid.
Too late.
Excuse me, sir.
need to ask you a few questions.
I'm Special Agent Winston, son of Steve Banerjee. You're under arrest for 3 counts of solicitation of murder.
Just step this way, please.
But I left my luggage.
That's all right.
In light of the weight of the direct evidence, much of it in the words of the defendant, we won't insist on a sentence of life imprisonment. However, there are 2 charges of conspiracy to murder, 4 charges of solicitation to murder. These are serious offenses. 4 years for each felony charge. That's 24 years, plus 3 years for the RICO charge. 26 years maximum.
How much time will I have to serve?
Federal requires that you serve at least 21 years. You'll also suffer forfeiture of all your business assets to federal authorities under the provisions of the RICO Act. At the end of your sentence, your immigration status will be revoked. You'll be deported back to India.
Lindsay, I sent you this drawing. It's a portrait of Christian.
I really miss the children, Irene. I really miss them. Please, give them my love.
It's gonna be all right, sweetheart. When they send you to a permanent facility, then I can come and visit you. I can bring the kids.
No, I don't want them to see me in jail. I don't want you to tell them that I'm...
Stephen, what is gonna happen? The lawyers are telling me that the government is gonna take over everything. Chippendales. The Sabe Corporation, the house, just everything.
I won't let that happen. Irene, I promise you, I won't let them take Chippendales away.
Court is now in session. Please be seated.
On the first count, conspiracy to murder Nicholas DeNoia, how do you plead?
I plead guilty, Your Honor.
On the second count, conspiracy to murder David Lewis and Mark Carollo, how do you plead?
I plead guilty, Your Honor.
Accepted by the court. Mr. Banerjee will be returned here for sentencing this coming Tuesday, October the 24th, unless there are any objections by counsel.